This is crazy because I've seen footage. Your video, so now I'm in your video.
Quick! Before you watch this video, there are some spoilers for Simon, you know, the Simon verse, love Simon. So if
just Simon. I feel
Simon
like,
in general.
Yeah, you're cool. If you haven't read Upside or Leah yet, you're safe to watch
okay.
this.
But Simon, spoilers. So don't watch this video if you don't want to be spoiled for the story of Simon or love Simon.
Yeah. And while you're not watching this video yet, go see the movie.
Yeah.
And come back watch this
and
video.
Then you can watch the video. Hey BookTubers, it's the Hufflepuffle here, and today I am joined with the most special guest to ever grace this channel.
I'm a fellow Hufflepuff.
Yes, the author of these incredible books. Now, number one New York Times best-selling author.
That's very new.
Of Leah Duffy.
That has not yet sunk in.
It's been, what, 3 days?
Yeah. 2 days.
Two days? Three.
Something like that.
Something like that.
And I did not see that coming. Also, that was...
I did.
That was... Yeah, I did not. I
know you didn't. Because you told us, you were like, it's not going to make the list at all. And I was like...
Yeah. Well, I just wanted to kind of preempt, because my expectation was that it was not going to make the list, and that I was going to have a bunch of people kind of wanting to know why, and it was going to have to, like, pretend to be really chill about the fact that it didn't make the list, because it's like, I don't know why I even cared about it. It was just, like, kind of that one thing I'd never... done.
Yeah.
You know, like, Simon, even with the movie, has never hit the list and will never hit the list because it's always going to be competing with its own paperback.
Right.
But my girl did it. I'm kind of glad it was Leah, too. Like, Leah just, like, she's like, step aside, Simon.
Yeah. Like, she's like, listen, I got this.
Yeah.
So, I had a very, very awesome question from my friend Kevs, and wants to know, how many Oreos does it take to get sad Becky and happy Becky?
Well, also, hi Kez, I know you, hi. I feel like, this is complicated because, like, even just the expectation and anticipation of an Oreo is enough to kind of, you know.
I see.
I'm like, it doesn't take much.
Right.
I mean, I do want to emphasize too that, like, no, we should not stop at one just because I'm already happy.
Oh, okay.
Lindsay Lohan from Mean Girls, and she's just like, the limit does not exist. Like, that's how many I want.
Okay. So. I got it. I had the idea for a fun little kind of sorting game when it comes to road trips.
Okay.
So I was thinking, if all of your characters from these three lovely books somehow got a giant van and went on a road trip together, what kind of, like, roles would they have? Like, who would do the most driving?
Graham.
Who would be in charge of the snacks?
Graham.
Who would be in charge of the music?
Leah.
Okay, and who would spend the entire time napping in the backseat?
Simon.
And that kind
and
of,
Nick.
Yeah.
And Garrett.
Yep.
I just, wait, so I, like, picked this, here's how I picture it, is, like, okay, big van.
Yeah.
Graham driving.
Mm-hmm.
Leah riding shotgun.
Yeah.
Then Abby's, like, in the middle seat in the back, but, like, right behind the driver's seat, like, leaning up, like, you know, having opinions about the music and things like that. She's, like, engaged.
Yeah.
Nick sleeping that way. Simon sleeping that way. Garrett in the very back. He's, like, stuck back there, sleeping.
Perfect.
That's the squad. That's the road trip.
Excellent.
The
Love
whole
it.
Time. That's it.
That's perfect. Now, we know that Simon is a Hufflepuff. We know that Leah is a Slytherin. What, are there any, like, side characters that you have house opinions about that you haven't necessarily shared?
Well, Molly's a Hufflepuff.
Yeah.
And that was actually very important when writing Leah, because it is surprisingly, like, really different to write from the point of view of Slytherin versus a Hufflepuff. Like, I had no issues, like, writing from a boy's point of view or anything like
that.
It's just the Slytherin. That's just a very different voice. But, yeah, so Molly's Hufflepuff. My new guy, Arthur, is a Gryffindor. Nick is a Ravenclaw. Bram invented Ravenclaw. Like, he is the epitome of Ravenclaw. Who else? I don't know. I think some of them. I don't know that I've sorted everybody. Garrett. I feel like Garrett, that's the one where I'm going to be like, comments, let us know what house you think Garrett Laughlin belongs in.
What else do you think?
Yeah.
Angel Bro.
I'm dying to know.
Belongs in. We want to know.
Yeah.
So put it in the comments.
Like, that's like a YouTube thing.
That's the YouTuber
right?
thing. You gotta tell them to put it in the comments. Leave a thumbs up, put it in the comments below.
And if you like this video, please subscribe.
Wow.
Right? Do it. Yes. Watch a lot of cake decorating videos.
Oh, that's like perfect.
They
You're
always,
an expert.
They say that, yeah.
You nailed it.
Yeah.
Let's talk about What If It's Us.
What If It's Us?
Real quick. So, What If It's Us with Adam Silvera. How was, like, the experience of writing with someone else versus just on your own lonesome path?
Yeah, no, it was different, and it was by far the most fun I've ever had writing a book, and I hate drafting. Right now I'm trying to draft another book alone. I'm like, this sucks. I need Adam to write half this book. I would like to only write books with Adam Silvera now, and it was scary at first because both of us are very, very private when we draft.
Yeah.
Like, we don't show anybody our messy first drafts. It's like, I don't know. I know, like, I'm super neurotic about it, as is he, as are we both about most things, but drafting is one of the things that we were neurotic about, and we really had to, like, get past that and be with each other and show each other very, very early versions of the work so we could A, kind of bounce off each other, and B, because even though we had it all pretty closely outlined, we knew, like, what was going to happen, you know, like, so much of it just kind of came together as we were writing it,
right.
just things sort of played back and forth, and then just being able to really, really capture the other person's character's voice, because that was a surprise for me. I had to know Ben as well as I know Arthur. Like, I had to write Ben's dialogue. I had to know Dylan, Ben's best friend, based on David Arnold, as well as I know Arthur. Dylan just wormed his way. This book should really be called, like, What If It's Us and Dylan? hi, David. You're in that. You know you're in that book, so you've read it. You know.
Real quick, before we wrap it up, Love, Simon. Movie. You had a movie based on your book. On your
I
words.
Cannot, yeah.
And it was amazing.
It's my favorite movie. I've seen it 12 times on purpose, and I intend to see it again. I'm gonna find a theater in Georgia, and I'm gonna see it again because I cannot get enough of it. I'm so excited, and I should also say the DVD is coming out very, very soon, and I personally recommend that you order it from Target. Because I had written Simon and Blue emails. So, you know, there's the extra emails that come in the special edition. This is the next group that comes after the special edition emails. And they are part of a Target exclusive, like, bonus content pack with the DVD.
Get the DVD if you can. Get it from Target.
If you can, that's what I recommend.
Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, you should subscribe.
Definitely subscribe.
It's my favorite because I put out a lot of videos.
Click on that bell for notifications.
Yeah! Thank you for watching. I will see you guys in my next video. I won't be with Becky, unfortunately, but I'll be there. So if you like my face, you can watch my next one, and I'll see you then. No mourners, no funerals. Eat Oreos. So I surrender.